guys, Matt from Pangea Reptile here with Tom and Anthony. We're back again to talk a little bit more about some crested gecko genetics, specifically colors. We're fresh off of a Tinley weekend, so forgive us if we're a little slow. But we were talking a little bit earlier about chromatophores and how that kind of the mechanism plays in the firing up and firing down. So I want to hear what you guys have to say about that.
All right, chromatophore, that's a good question, actually. You can actually also go on Foundation Genetics. If people haven't read the document, please go have a look. You can find it on Little Monster's website. And you'll be able to find chromatophore towards the bottom of the page. It's a chromatophore dermal unit. So on top of the top layer, you have skin. It's a dermis. And then just below that, you have the chromatophore unit. So it's three layers. The very bottom layer is where you're going to find melanin. The middle layer is where you'll find eridiforce.
Yep.
And that's what like reflects light and changes things and makes green coloration, blue coloration, and you can get white coloration.
So even if green and blue doesn't actually exist due to like reflection and refraction, maybe
we can make it.
We can make it appear that way.
Yes.
Yep. Gotcha.
You have a soft scale line, right? Soft scale modifies the actual structure.
Right.
Let me know what colors have you seen with that?
So I'm getting the green tone, which happens to come from some of the brown melanin in a lot of the animals. The blue tone when they're lacking the brown melanin. Some of the new things that we're looking at are hypos to show us some of that. And they're working as tools to identify it in our animals right now.
So that's one way to modify structure on the animal to see slightly different colors or hues of color. So they're not actually producing that color,
right?
But they will reflect that color back,
right.
Similar to what you find with like chameleons and anoles.
Okay. So through breeding, we're kind of genetically selecting ones that reflect in
light,
a different way.
Yeah. Right. And it has to do with color granules and how they, there's two ways to do it. So they can either reflect a certain way or with chameleons, what you'll get is you'll get the color granules that will stretch and compress on the animal due to hormones and whatever it is that they're getting stressed in their environment. And when you see that, what happens during that mechanism is that it's actually trapping certain wavelengths of light.
Yeah.
And so only blue or only green will reflect.
Very cool.
And then on the topmost unit of the chromatophore unit, you have eridiforce, and that's where you get anywhere between red to yellow coloration. Including oranges and those color tones in between.
Absolutely.
Yep. Good. So with the incomplete dominance of the base colors, that's where we're getting these variations of colors. Sometimes you get the peach, so you're getting the orange or yellow and red mixing, intermixing, because incomplete dominant, you tend to get that layering or intermix or blending. So it's a really quick way to tell incomplete dominance, and most traits are incomplete dominant. So that's what we're looking at visually. Aside from the structure, what we see as people, and we explain it a certain way based on visual interpretation versus structure and what's actually happening inside that was already discussed.
Right.
You guys, if you're just joining us for the first time, make sure you check out the first video that we did that helps explain some of this. And Anthony's website, littlemonsters.com, has a lot of information there for you guys. And
Facebook.
I'm sorry?
LM Reptiles.
That's what I said, LM Reptiles.
Yeah,
just like
I heard.
Just like I said.
I was just repeating it.
And then there's a Facebook page. That is what?
Foundation Genetics.
Foundation Genetics on Facebook. Check
on there, you can ask us questions. Yep. Tom and I will usually respond.
It's actually
we'll try to get Matt in there to respond to you guys too.
Maybe someday.
It's actually Crested Gecko Foundation Genetics on Facebook.
There we go.
And if you want to see a little bit of what I talked about with the green and blue reflecting back at you, if you go on Geckological on Instagram, you'll see some animals on there that are showing that. Thanks for watching our videos.
Make sure you like and subscribe.
And check out our latest videos, and don't forget to read the Foundation Genetics Guide.